Glassy visuals are clean, minimal ways to spice up your projects. So, today we're gonna try three interesting ways to use the effect inside Adobe After Effects. Alright, the first way is to create a glass card on top of a sharp background. It's an effect called glass morphism, mostly in UI design, and it gives you a modern look. So I have a few backgrounds here, and the first thing I'm gonna do is to create my card using the shape tool. Then align it to the center. I'll rename it to glass, and change it to an adjustment layer by turning this circle on. Now that it's not a solid layer, let's go ahead and add the fast box blur to the layer to make it look glassy. The amount of blur depends on your taste, but I'll go with 45. Next, I'm gonna duplicate the layer and call it stroke. Let's uncheck the adjustment icon and delete the blur. Now set the fill to none and give it a white little stroke like 4. I like it bold, but if you want to have a subtle edge, bring down the opacity and the stroke amount to make it minimal. Now we can add text on our card, and it looks interestingly simple. To make it a bit more pronounced, we can also add a drop shadow to the text, adjust the settings to your liking, and done. Piece of cake, right? Now if I change the background, you can see that the reflection on the glass changes based on the background colors. And that's what makes it a bit realistic. Just remember that there should be some kind of sharp background behind the card to form a glass effect. It doesn't work on a background that's already blurry. Okay, for the second technique, I have a background again as well as a simple logo animation. Now this one needs a photo of glass texture, so I'm gonna make a comp with my texture and drag it on top of the layers in the main comp. Then I'll duplicate the layer and position them left and right, like the two sides of a barn door or window. And keyframe their position to make them open to reveal the logo behind. Next, I'll make a duplicate of each layer and rename them to be able to link them properly later on. Now these two copies are going to be the map for the glass texture of each side, so it's very important for them to have the same position and movement of the main layers. I'll pre-compose the texture layers, move all the attributes, and turn them off. Then I'll turn the main layers into adjustment layers and begin adding some effects to them. First, I'll add the fast box blur as the basis of a glass layer. Then the transform effect to enlarge what's behind it, like some real glasses, by scaling it up to 105. Next is the curves effect to make things brighter a little. And finally, what's gonna make our texture to pop up is the displacement map. Set the map layer to the duplicate texture layer behind it, and set the horizontal displacement to something like 25. And there it is, our glass texture. Now let's copy all the effects to the other half and change the displacement map to the layer beneath it. And this is the glass door we want. Now to make them more realistic, let's create beveled edge for the glass by going inside one of the main glass layers since they're duplicates, and double click on the rectangle tool to make a mask around the texture. Then while the layer is selected, go to the effects, add a stroke, and set the brush size to something like 15 or whatever that suits your glass. And now they have a nice edge. Let's get a preview. Not bad. You can also use this technique to make a glass card if you wanted to have realistic glass texture. For the last one, I want to create some kind of glassy transition between this shot, where these two lovebirds are somehow close, to this one, where they are much closer. So I'll draw a rectangle using the shape tool like this. Then I turn it into an adjustment layer as usual and add the fast box blur, as well as transform, curves, and one little optional effect called chromatic aberration, which is a free plugin from Plugin Everything. I'll change the position offset for red and blue to something like 13. and you can see what a nice effect it has. Then I'll duplicate the glass layer, make it a bit thinner, and fill the frame on each side. Now we should trim the layers to be a few frames long on each clip. Next, I'll make a keyframe for their position as they are. Then for the beginning of the transition, I'll drag them to the left and drag them to the right for the end of it. So they enter from the left side, spread out in the middle, then go out from the right side. I'll easy ease the keyframes by selecting them and pressing F9. And this is how they move. Now let's randomize their opacity for differentiation, so that the middle one is bolder. And with a little sound effect, we have a nice glassy transition between our shots. And that's a wrap. Hope you learned something new, my fellow creators. Good luck!